Welcome to MOSCON 2016. We have with us Dr. Sri Ganesh, who is the director of Netradhama, a renowned phaco surgeon from Bangalore. We know him for all his fast, super fast phaco surgeries, and he has used several lenses and is well known for all the special multifocal newest lenses in the market. We would like to know from you, sir, which is your preferred multifocal that you use as of today in patients, and what would be the machine that you would recommend for a new surgeon or even an advanced one?
Let's go to the machines first. Today I demonstrated the Signature Pro, right, which is the latest machine in the market from AMO. And how it differs from the earlier Signature is that they've improved the fluidics, they've improved the response time, and it's about 5 times faster, the response time, than the Signature. It takes just about 4 milliseconds for sensing, and it has a sampling rate of about 250 times per second, so it's very fast, and the fluidics are excellent. So you can go to very high parameters. I normally use 60 flow rate and 650 vacuum, so the surgery is very fast. And it also has a system known as CASA, which is basically for analysis of your case. So it gives you all the turnover time, the amount of phaco energy I've used, the vacuum settings, everything. So you can do a complete analysis of your case. You can also compare it with other cases. And it's a good analytical tool. It also has a surgical media center, which is records in high definition and has all the parameters and a good teaching tool. Apart from that, it's got a wireless foot pedal. So that is quite convenient. And this is something which I used today for the live surgery, and I found it quite nice. Coming to the intraocular lenses, the various intraocular lenses in the market, so it's quite confusing as to what to use. Basically, I look at the patient's demographics, the lifestyle, and other aspects, their expectations when selecting a multifocal. If they are driving actively at night on highways, then I avoid multifocals, because most of the multifocals have some amount of dysphotopsia, and there are some patients who may not adapt to it. The latest lenses are the extended depth of field lenses, which gives you an extended depth of field of about 1.5 to 1.75 diopters. So they give you good distance and intermediate vision. But the near vision is not that great. So if the patient wants to read without glasses, then you'll have to do a micromonovision and then undercorrect the non-dominant eye by about 0.5 to 0.75 diopters to give them good reading. But the advantage of this lens is that it has a continuous range of vision from distance to intermediate to up till 40 centimeters. But patients are reading close up, then they may either have to wear weak readers, or you have to do a micromonovision for the other eye. The advantage of this technology, which combines a proprietary HLED design and achromatic technology to increase the contrast, is that the MTF or the transmission is excellent. Light transmission is excellent, and the contrast is similar to that of a monofocal, or even better. And definitely the other multifocals, it's almost double, the contrast is double that of the other multifocal lenses. You can have some amount of dysphotopsia, night vision problems like glare and halos. About 20 to 25% of patients can have this. But then over a period of time it reduces. So this is something that I have seen. I used nearly about 200 of these lenses. The specific indications for this lens are, if a patient has a monofocal in the other eye and emmetropic for distance, if he wants some reading, then this is a good lens to use. Because if you use a multifocal in the other eye, then the difference in the contrast is too much and the patient is uncomfortable. So normally if there's a monofocal in one eye, you don't put a multifocal, but you can put a symphony and then aim for about 0.5 diopters under correction or myopia, and then the patient 0.5 diopters of over correction, that is myopia, and then the patient will be able to read comfortably. So this is something which we are doing. There's a special indication for this lens. The other special indication is post-refractive surgery.
I remember you saying that.
Because post-refractive surgery, there can be errors in biometry. Right. Your biometry is not exact. So for a multifocal lens, you have to be exactly on dot. Otherwise, it's not very forgiving. And post-refractive surgery, there are a lot of induced abrasions. Right. So with a multifocal lens, then you're again further increasing the abrasions, but the quality of vision is very poor. Mm-hmm. But with the symphony, since the contrast is very good, then this is not an issue. And the induced aberrations are very low. Plus, it is more forgiving for small errors in biometry because you have an increased depth of field. And we have done about nearly 10-12 post-refractive surgery cases, and the satisfaction is quite good. So these are special indications for these lenses. I've also used it in case of traumatic cataract where one eye the patient has a normal lens, a clear lens, young patients, other eye they want some amount of depth. So you put in a symphony, it gives you distance to intermediate. And anyway, they are accommodating with the other eye, and the contrast is kind of match, so they're quite comfortable. So these are the three specific indications for the symphony extended range of vision.
Great. So symphony is the next step to go. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.